Two separate accidents have left a total of 15 people dead and several others injured. The first incident involved a collision between motor vehicles. Registration number UBE 939H, a Toyota Hiace, and a trailer. Registration number RSC 603Q/RL. Which occurred at approximately 11:45 p.m. at Musiti along Jinja Iganga Road. This accident resulted in the loss of 9 lives. According to the Superintendent of Police, Michael Kananura, the incident was a result of the speeding driver of motor vehicle, registration number UBE 939H, which collided with a stationary trailer from the rear. The trailer had broken down along the highway due to a mechanical fault and had not placed any emergency warning signs or reflectors to alert other road users. The second accident occurred at Namasoga along Jinja Iganga Highway, claiming the lives of 6 individuals. According to the Busoga East Region Police spokesperson, Diana Nandaula, the accident involved 3 vehicles, a Toyota Hiace, registration number UFV 659L, an Isuzu Tipa, number UBH 032W, and a Toyota Sienta, number UBJ 679Y.
The accident that occurred yesterday involved 3 vehicles that included a Tipa lorry, a taxi, and a Toyota Sienta. And it occurred when the Tipa lorry that was carrying sand got a tire burst, lost control, and had a head-on collision with the taxi that was coming from the side of Jinja. And in the process, the Sienta that was following the Tipa rammed into the Tipa lorry from the rear, causing an injury of 6 people who died on the way to hospital. At the moment, the injured are still undergoing treatment and investigation into the accident is ongoing.
This accident was caused by the Tipa, which rammed into our taxi after it got a tire burst. I'm now feeling a lot of pain after my legs were broken. I'm waiting for the doctors to direct me on what to do. Some of the deceased in the evening accidents were identified as Leia Kadia Nyangoba, 60 years, a resident of Luka, Yahaya Kenyatta, a resident of Busia, and Juma Batwara, a resident of Iganga, among others. The deceased and the survivors from the evening accidents were taken to Iganga Hospital. At the hospital, health workers were overwhelmed with the situation as they were seen working tirelessly to save the lives of the survivors. Sam Obira, one of the administrators at the hospital, has asked the public to help them identify the unclaimed bodies.
I urge whoever might be having a relative that is missing, that might have went for a journey or might have traveled on Friday till yesterday, to come and trace and all look at the lying bodies in the mortuary.
Road users have faulted the traffic police for failure to remove stationary vehicles from the road, even after a directive over the matter was passed by Parliament.
My appeal to traffic is to take away all the cars, muscle lorries that are stuck on the road. You know, we have very narrow roads. It's very hard to go from here up to Kenya without getting those trucks on the road. Yet they are stuck. Some even stay there for over 4 days. This causes accidents, and that's why we're going to lose so many people, especially on this road.
Other victims who died in both accidents included Peter Isabidie, the taxi driver, commonly known as Rupida, Rachel Naisanga, a former councillor in Kariro Town Council, who has been a staff at National Insurance Company, Lukman Seruwaji, commonly known as Lukman Fashions, who has been a prominent designer in Iganga Town, among others. Report compiled by Ivan Wachibi for the news.